The combo chart is suitable for comparing two sets of measure values that are usually hard to compare because of the differences in scale. A typical example is when you have a bar chart with sales figures and want to combine these figures with the margin values in percent. With a combo chart, you can combine these values by, for example, using bars for the sales values and a line for the margin values. By default, the bars have the measure axis on the left and the margin values have a separate axis to the right. While the two measures use the same dimension, in this case, product group. If you have yet another measure with values that are roughly in the same range as the sales values, you can add the third measure as bars and either stack or group the new measure values with the sales values. With grouped bars, you can easily compare two or more items in the same categorical group. Stacked bars combine bars of different groups on top of each other, and the total height of the resulting bar represents the combined result. The combo chart is ideal when you want to present measure values that are normally hard to combine because of the significant difference in value ranges. It can also be quite useful when comparing values of the same value range. The combo chart is the best choice when combining several measures of different value ranges. The combo chart only supports one dimension and can therefore not be used when you need to include two or more dimensions in the visualization. To create a combo chart, drag and drop the combo chart onto your sheet. Add a dimension, for example, product group. Then add a measure, for example, sales quantity. Then add a second measure, for example, margin percentage. This will create a combo chart showing the product group and the sales quantity as bars and the margin percentage as a line. You can format your combo chart in different ways. In this example, we are going to create a new chart with region name as dimension. Then we add three measures to the chart. You can only have one dimension, but you can continue adding up to 15 measures. When finished, we can change the appearance of the chart. For example, you can show the sales target measure as a marker, and you can do the same for the sales cost amount. To differentiate it from the previous marker, you can show this as a line. In this example, we add customer as dimension and total shipment as a measure. Then you can exclude null values and you can limit the number of values to the top 15. Then you can compare the total shipment with the other two values. In this case, the on-time shipments and the late shipments. When done, you can select bars for both measures. This way, you can see the ratio between on-time and late shipments at a glance. Bars can be showed grouped or stacked. By selecting stacked, you can see the combined result of different groups displayed by the total height of the bar. And that concludes this video. Thanks for watching.